The anti-terrorist operation, or an anti-terrorist operation by the Jammu and Kashmir police this week, in which two terrorists were killed, has left a trail of destruction behind. More than 15 houses have been severely damaged, some razed entirely, leaving many families homeless in the time of coronavirus.
Currency worth 1,30,000 meant to repair the house, sewing machines, the means of livelihood, all personal records, all charred. 55-year-old Bashir Ahmed Darzi has lost everything he had built when bombs hit his three-story home in downtown Srinagar. The anti-terror operation, in which two terrorists were killed on Wednesday, has left a trail of destruction. More than 15 residential houses have been badly damaged.
मेरा ये फादर है, इसका एक ही सहारा था ये मशीन, ये रोजगार था हमारे लिए, और मैं खुद मिस्त्री काम करता हूँ। मैं महीने का 4-5 हजार रुपए कमाता हूँ, मैं भी पूरा ट्रेनिड नहीं हूँ। ये देखिए आप, कैश देखिए सर, हमने स्लेब के लिए रखा 1,30,000 रुपए हमने रखा था स्लेब के लिए, वो भी सब कुछ जल चुका है। इन्होंने कुछ निकालने ही नहीं दिया सर, हमारे कपड़े भी तक नहीं, ये दूसरे का कपड़ा लगा हुआ, ये भी दूसरे का कपड़ा है।
Since January this year, there have been 28 encounters in the valley in which 65 militants were killed. During encounters, security forces use heavy weapons like mortar and IEDs to bring down houses where they think terrorists take shelter. Official sources say more than 100 houses have been razed to the ground in security operations in the last 1 year. Hilal Ahmed says he was woken up after the police barged into his home at 2 a.m. and took him out. What followed was blasts and heavy firing.
जो कुछ भी घर में था, घर में सब कुछ होता है ना, वो भी खत्म हो गया है। सिर्फ मुझे, मेरे पास एक इनर बचा है जो मुझे पहनना था, और एक पाजामा बस।
Nusrat, a single parent to two daughters, was stuck inside her home with a bedridden mother-in-law when the firing broke out. She says her family was the last one to be evacuated, but when they returned, there was nothing left. Security forces say these processes are essential SOPs they have to follow. Experts say using heavy weapons to destroy target houses is meant to prevent casualties on security forces during encounters. It also serves as a warning to those who give shelter to terrorists. Meanwhile, in the neighborhood, the local mosque committee has already collected 1.6 crore rupees for the rehabilitation of families. The committee says an initial compensation of rupees 2 lakh to each victim family has already been given. Officials say Srinagar Red Cross has provided rupees 5,000 to each victim family.
ये घर में अगर मिलिट्रेंट था तो 20 घरों को क्यों इन्होंने आग लगाया? इसीलिए हमने मुकामी तौर पर फैसला किया, हम इनको, इनके घरों को अब नए तरीके से, नई सूरत में बनाएंगे। हम जमा कर रहे हैं और हमने इनको दिया तकरीबन 40 लाख रुपए हमने दिया इनको।
For the last few years, target houses are being destroyed during anti-militancy operations as part of an aggressive security doctrine in Kashmir. After every encounter, people are losing homes and whatever they have built in their lives. Here in this downtown neighborhood, for killing two militants, more than 15 families had to pay a very heavy price. With cameraman Amir, Nazir Masoodi for NDTV.